Hi! Всем привет, дорогие друзья! So, I welcome everybody at my channel, PTL, Pavel Tutors Languages. So, just to keep it simple, what I do, I extract the article from newspapers and I just present this paragraph here. I underline specific endings, explain the meaning of it and dive into analysis of Russian grammar. Since there is a lot of writing here, I will probably move myself retrograde backward so you could see, so you will not always see me on the screen. So let's start. I'm going to read first in a slow motion. No, I'm just joking. First I'm going to read slowly, then I will read in a normal speed, and then we will go to the translation. Целя обеспечения социальной поддержки и сохранения доходов семей, имеющих детей, поставляю произвести единовременную выплату гражданам, проживающим в России и являющимся родителями. That was the slow speed, normal speed. В целях обеспечения социальной поддержки и сохранения доходов семей, имеющих детей, поставляю произвести единовременную выплату гражданам, проживающим в России и являющимися родителями. What that means? It is in the goal or for the purpose of securing the social support and preserving the incomes of the families having children, поставляю, I order to realize or to produce one-time payment to citizens who have been living or who live in Russia and who seem to be or who are being parents. This is what that means. So let me go right now to the details. V is a preposition. Celia, number one. Number one is the purpose. This word is in the plural form, in the celia. The singular of that is cel. Since it is in the plural form, that's why we are seeing here this ending. So, it is for all genders, and it is in the propositional case, and that's why we have to add the ending ya, so we could have it in the right proper case. Обеспечение, number two. Secure. Обеспечить is the verb. Обеспечение is a noun. So, обеспечение is in this form. Обеспечение. Why? Because it's, first of all, it's a neutral word in a genitive case. Обеспечение. We have to remove I and add я. Обеспечение. Целья. Обеспечение. Социально. Number three. Social. In this case, that social is an adjective in a genitive case. And it has the ending oi. Why? Because it is related to the number four, which is the support. That means поддержки. Remember that adjective always modifies the noun that follows. So, since it is the genitive case, we have to add ending oi. Социальной. Next one, поддержки. Поддержка is a noun in a genitive case. So, поддержка is support. It's a feminine noun in a genitive case. Поддержка. And because if it is in a genitive case, we have to remove a and add ки. Поддержка, поддержки. И, that's the end, that's the connection. Сохранение, number five. A reservation or the preservation. So, сохранение is a neuter noun. It is in the genitive case. Сохранение. We have to remove I, that E, and add я. Сохранение. So, сохранение. Доходов. Доходов, number six. It's an income in the plural. So, it's a noun in the plural form. And доход is a masculine word in the genitive case. And that's why we have to add to it OV. Доходов. Семя, number seven. It's a family, семья. It is a noun, feminine. It is in the plural case and in the genitive case. In that case, we have to remove from the semia ya and add to it yu, semei. Imeyushi. Number 8 is to have, from the infinitive imet. This is the active present participle form in a case. So how do we get to this form? Other to take that word imet, ya imeyut, imeyush, ani imeyut. We will have to remove the T from that and add to that stem imeyu ending for the masculine shchi, for the feminine shchaya, for neuter shchoye, and for the plural shchie. But what we have here, we have ending k, imeyu shchi. In that case, we have to put it into that imeyu, we have to put it into a proper form, so it has a proper case. That's why we have to add it, imeyu shchi. Dieti, number 9, children, dieti, so children. Now, it is a in a nominative case, it will be dieti, since it is a plural, and in an accusative case, we have to add yu, dieti yu. Accusative case, that means that we are referring to something directly to the somebody, or to the object, or to the person. Next one, postavliayu, postavliayu is the verb in the first singular, ya postavliayu. It comes from the verb to order something. So it's a present tense, ya postavliayu, ty postavliayesh, on postavliayesh, etc., etc., etc. Prazvesti, we are just adding an infinitive to this one. Prazvesti, that means to realize or to produce, just prazvesti. Yedinovremenuyu, number 12, is a one-time. And it is in adjective form, yedinovremennaya. Now, adjective form in this one, on the number 12, is, first of all, adjective, and it modifies the number 13, which is viplata. That's why always adjective modifies the noun that follows. Now, since that viplata is in the feminine case, that is in accusative case, it's a viplata is feminine noun. This has to be yegin vremenu viplatu, so it is in an accusative case. And since it is an accusative case, we have to add ending uyu. Yegin vremenuyu viplatu, number 13. Number 13 is the payment. The noun viplata is feminine in the nominative case. But if we place it into accusative case, we have to remove a and add u. Viplatu in the nominative case. In the accusative case. Grazhdanam, it's in the plural form. The singular form is grazhdan. Grazhdanam, number 14, citizen. So it's a noun in the plural form. And since we are giving it to someone, it's a dative case, we give it to someone, we have to add in the plural form ending am. Grazhdanam. Prajivayushchim. What that means? It comes from the infinitive, it's number 15, from the infinitive prajivayush. Since it is in the accusative, in the active present participle, how do we create it? Ya prajivayu, ki prajivayush, until we get to the third person plural. Ani prajivayut. We will remove the T, and to add, we are adding that participle form, prajivayushchi, for masculine, prajivayushchaya, for feminine, prajivayushchoye, for neuter, and prajivayushchie, for plural. And now, prajivayushchim, why do we have in here? Because we, in the this case, we have to, in the dative case, so we have to give it to someone, so we have to add the ending prajivayushchim, because it's in the plural, prajivayushchim. That's when we get the final case form. V is preposition, rasiyu. If we are using preposition V, then the following word will be always, this is number 16, so it's Russia, it's Russia. It will be in the, it's a preposition, so this has to be also in the prepositional case. Rasiya in a nominative case, we have to remove ya and add I, because it's a prepositional case. Rasiya. I That means, again, являющимися. That's a complicated word. It's coming from the verb являться. It's a reflexive verb. How do we get to this form? Again, since this is active, present participle, я являюсь, являемся, ты являешься, until we get to the third person plural, они являются, we will have to remove тся, put it on the side, till will be removed, ся is on the side because it will be added eventually back, and again, являющийся for masculine, являющаяся for feminine, являющуюся for neutral, and являющиеся for plural. And then, in this number 17, we go back. It is active present participle, but it is in the instrumental case. That's why we have to add imi, являющими, and then we have to add back sia, because it's a reflexive word. That's why we have являющимися. Last one, родителями. That's number 18. Number 18 are the parents. Родителями is in the plural case. It is in the instrumental case, and that's why we have to add the ending yami. Являющимися родителями. Okay? So I hope this was quite clear. And if you have any comments or questions, just please click and provide for me some feedback. Thank you and bye-bye. До свидания, друзья.